Hey YouTube, Koppersen here. The 16th anniversary update has been released, and with it comes the Hotel Maple event. This event is amazing for leveling up characters, and there are, as always, a ton of goodies to collect as well. As you start the event, you will collect your very own personal VIP membership card, just like everyone else. This card can be accessed at any time through the event star at the left side of your screen. The event itself can be accessed starting from level 101. Your card can be upgraded to a different level, and there are 4 levels in total. VIP, which everyone gets, VIP Elite, VIP Premium, and VIP Prestige. You can purchase a VIP membership point once a day per server for 200 coins. After 5 days of buying these membership points, you will reach VIP Elite. After 15 days of buying points in total, you will reach VIP Premium. And after 35 days of buying these points, you will reach the marvelous VIP Prestige. Every day that you purchase a membership point, you will get a skill point as well that you can distribute in your very own special VIP passive skill. These skills are server-wide, so they count for all your characters on your server. There are skills like increasing EXP obtained, increasing damage against monsters or boss monsters, increasing critical rate, etc, etc. Personally, I'm going for that EXP obtained and normal monster damage first, just so I can train a bit faster. And again, the effects and level of your VIP page are server-wide, so all your characters who started the event will benefit from it. It takes 1 point to rank up a skill to level 1, 2 points to rank up to level 2, and you guessed it, 3 points to rank up to level 3. Every time you purchase a membership point, you will also get a special coupon. Talk to the VIP coupon book to open up this store. These coupon tickets are server-wide as well, so it doesn't matter on which character you purchase the membership point. Those selective slot coupons, double EXP coupons, and gold potential stamps are definitely on my wishlist. And finally, every time you upgrade your pass fully, you'll get a nice goodie as well. Once you reach VIP Elite, you'll get an EXP Nodestone, which is amazing for leveling up your 5th job Nodestones. You'll get 100 Arcane Symbol Select coupons if you reach Premium, and a leveling potion that can be used between level 200 and level 239 once you reach VIP Prestige. So buying these membership points is super important, but there are other benefits as well. So after 5 days of buying membership points, you rank up and reach VIP Elite, and that will also unlock the Infinity Pool. This pool can be found at the top of the hotel and can only be accessed by those VIP Elite members. For 100 coins, you can drop one of your characters in this pool once a day for anywhere between 1 and 10 level ups. But this event is only available for characters between level 141 and 199. This event is quite similar to the Goblin Night Market and recent Fairy event. However, it gets better. Once you upgrade your pass to Premium, you'll be able to enter the Infinity Pool twice a day. And once you hit Prestige, you'll be able to enter the pool 3 times a day per server. That's freaking insane. Hypothetically, you could get from level 141 to level 171 in a matter of seconds. If you started buying membership points the day the update was released, you would be able to reach Prestige rank around the 25th of May if you purchase points every day. That would leave a total of 2 weeks of amazing leveling for your mules. This is by far the best leveling event we've had in a long time. That isn't burning, of course. By the way, if you are enjoying today's guide video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more Maple content. Make sure to hit the bell notification as well, so you never miss a video. It costs 100 coins to swim once, and those coins are also needed to upgrade your pass and are used to buy a ton of items in the stores around the hotel. Talk to the NPC Swanson to obtain a skill to start collecting coins. While hunting monsters, coins will automatically be collected every couple of monsters killed. If you want to speed this up, try using one of the spawn boosters to save some time. Think about Kishin or maybe a totem. Overall, it does only take about 15 to 30 minutes to reach the daily cap of 300 coins, so it isn't too bad. In Reboot, I advise to fight monsters that are lower level than you just so you can cap a bit faster. Unless you can one-shot them, of course. I usually go for monsters around 10 to 20 levels below my character on Reboot just for easier killing. Coins can also be obtained from playing minigames, which can be accessed at the top floor. Those do count towards your daily limit though. But you can also obtain coins from the One Punch King machine. Deal as much damage as you can to this machine within the time limit. The more damage you dealt, the higher your score. You'll then receive anniversary coins depending on your score, and every 10 points equals 1 coin. The coin reward from the punch machine does not count towards your daily limit, so you can exceed your 300 cap. So do this every day to get a nice chunk of additional coins. The max amount of coins you can get from this machine is 120. If you are more of a pacifist yourself, there is another way to get coins as well that doesn't involve murdering machines or monsters. tofu at the top left in the hotel sells chairs which will reward Sweet 16 points every few seconds. There's also a more expensive version of this chair which will cost 170 million mesos that will collect those Sweet 16 points twice as fast as the other one. Those chairs can only be used outside of the hotel and it does take a couple of hours to collect enough coins. So if you don't have enough time to actually play the game, this will help as well. Just leave it on overnight or something like that. There also is a chair that will give out EXP in this store as well. And of course, these aren't the only items Tofu sells. They also sell coupons that reward a piece of the previous anniversary event outfits, an Android that costs 200 coins if you're VIP Elite and 1000 if you're Premium. You'll need to collect 10 tickets to turn it in. Same for the vacation outfit and damage skin. The Android is not really worth it unless you don't have any in reboot because it gives a permanent heart, which is quite nice for reboot players. I myself though, I'm not going for that. But if this Android is on your wish list, I would suggest to cap coins on a character that isn't your main for this one. That way you won't hinder your progress for the other rewards. Talk to Louis to enter the jewelry store. The Chaos Ring is a very nice ring that can get its potential and bonus stats reset for free 10 times per week. I would recommend this ring to be the first ring you're going for. It has the best stats, and once you replace this one, you can change the potentials to, for example, drop rate, so that you can still use it as a drop gear item. The Adventure Deep Dark Critical Ring and Sylph Ring both have fixed potential. These lines are critical damage, so they're pretty nice as well, but the other ring is more flexible, which is definitely a plus. Another nice ring to get is the Synergy Ring, but you will need to obtain the same ring on 5 different characters for its effect to fully take place. The Synergy Ring can get potential as well though, so it is more flexible than the Deep Dark Critical Ring and the Sylph Ring. Gold Richie has his own Meso store as well, which mostly contains cosmetic items and a few usable items. I don't know what you all are thinking, but these items are a bit too expensive for my taste. And I kinda borrowed 10 billion from my fiancé to fund my Demon Slayer, and I haven't really fully paid that back yet, so I'm just skipping out on this one. Not in reboot though, because there in this store you will find droplets, which are extremely important for your progression later on. Make sure to buy those if you are in need of any droplets in reboot. Nicole has some nice items in her store that can be of use of you as well. I'm probably going to get the cube packs, separate cubes, stamps and nodestone boxes. But take a good look at your equipment for this store. Just think of whatever you need and buy that one. Most items in here are pretty useful. The items in this store are transferable within the world as well, and most of them can be bought multiple times as well. I'm going to grind on an additional character just to purchase a few more items from this store. Mason in the personal shop sells a couple of useful items as well. These items are not tradable though, keep that in mind. For example, the trade boost potion is a great way to instantly get enough charm to unlock your pocket slot. And those mysterious Monster Bloom and Monster Life gem coupons are pretty nice as well if you're going for these systems. We're actually going to do a 24-hour livestream this weekend, check us out, over at twitch.tv/coppersandtv. And I'm probably going to collect coins on every single class in the game just to purchase those mysterious Monster Blooms and Monster Life gem coupons. Alright, so the final part of this video is for all you min-maxers out there. It is recommended to not only cap coins on your main, because that's usually where you want to buy items on. And you don't want to spend your coins upgrading your pass on that character, so cap coins on a mule as well to rank up your VIP membership card instead. Besides that, I would cap coins on one additional character as well, just to buy whatever you want from Nicole. In the end, the more the merrier, so if you can cap on more characters then why not? Just be mindful to have some fun and don't burn out. The event is a great way to level up your characters for your Legion as well, so I would definitely take advantage of this event. The event lasts 49 days, which equals 14,700 coins. There are 7 sunny Sundays where we can get double the amount of coins, which is an additional 2,100 coins. So if you play every day of this event possible, you'll get 16,800 coins if my math is correct, and that, of course, that doesn't count any coins obtained from the Punch King event, and the 300 coins that you'll get from the Kid Ulti Day event that will be released next month. So if you are going hard for this event, plan your purchases accordingly. And that is the Hotel Maple event. Have fun, don't burn out capping coins, and perhaps see you during the 24-hour livestream later this week. And as always, many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Niels de Konnik, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Jeff Wong, Pinky Traveler, Terry Kim, Juju, Galaxy Art, Jesus Rodriguez, Varese, Ricer RU, Driesumker, Plux, Zenny, Wiley, Francisco Sousa, History Cannon, Backspace OTI, Simak, Safronex, Lonzo, BG Extremes, Harry Gardner, Ido Heiman, Anwar NHI, Brandon, Frank Bouguet, Ziggy Deer, Fine Asian Guy, Mr. Potemkin, Flidiot, Beamer WT, Lars Smits, Edjar, Naisu, and Chen125. If you would like to be mentioned here as well and get early access to new videos, make sure to check out the join button below this video. Thank you all so much for watching, stay safe, and happy mapling!